January 16th, 1990. This was the beginning of an expedition that would take us halfway around the world. It was sunny, 47 degrees, and hundreds of people gathered to wish us well. Spirits were high as Snowmobile fans met us along the way. The TV cameras caught the action, and Jason Davis from KSTP-TV followed the expedition's first few days. Scott Eilertson, Grigory Shulik, and Lee Bussey were on their way to the Soviet Union on snowmobiles. A stopover at the World Championship Snowmobile Races in Eagle River, Wisconsin, gave us a chance to meet Miss USSR, Yulia Tsukhanova, and former World Championship racers Bob Eastman and Roger Jansen.
The snowmobile trails that headed north out of Eagle River into the Upper Peninsula of Michigan were blessed with excellent snow conditions and beautiful scenery. The best time of the year truly must be winter. Only the wildlife were out on the trail before us during the early morning hours. We had the opportunity to see everything from deer to even a little pine marten. After a couple of hundred yards, walking in snow this deep, it sure felt good to get back on the snowmobiles again. The expedition traveled through the remote terrain and villages of northern Ontario, finding the snow getting deeper and deeper. The Jag AFS long tracks felt right at home in the deep powder snow. Many times we would be tired and exhausted, and we would feel all alone in the world. The peace and serenity on Lake Panage in Ontario was truly something to behold. I sometimes wish that lake would never end. Power lines served as trail markers for hundreds of miles. I will never forget all of our new friends we met along the trail. Snowmobilers are the friendliest people around. We shared many of the trails with everything from logging trucks to ATVs, always welcoming their smiles and waves. A stop at one of the many river crossings was always a good excuse for a rest and a good story. The weather was always full of surprises. It would rain, then turn to a snowy blizzard, where visibility was very limited, followed by bright sunny days with lots of warm, friendly folks to meet. Even the cross-country skiers enjoyed meeting our new Soviet friend, Grigory. Another popular form of transportation in Quebec is skating, where you can actually go from village to village following the rivers and lakes. After many difficult times crossing Ontario, trail marker signs of Quebec were a welcome sight. In French Quebec, there were some tense moments, fun times running flat out over a snow-covered lake, and warm, friendly families with cute little puppies. The three of us will truly miss Quebec. The final leg of our journey in North America took us through the beautiful New England states of Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine. The scenery was breathtaking as we headed east across the White Mountain Range. Some of the true highlights of our journey was having the opportunity to stop and visit many Arctic Cat dealers and snowmobile clubs along the way. We could never have done this if it wasn't for all their support. We crossed many bridges along the way, but by far the largest crossing was between the snowmobilers of North America and those of the Soviet Union.
We left the east coast of Maine and continued our journey across the Gulf of Finland, encountering thin ice, slush, and sometimes open water. Cookout was a great way to celebrate our last day in Finland with our new friends. It sure felt good to be snowmobiling on solid ground again. The Soviet border is almost in sight. One last stop to check over our gear, we prepare to begin a lifelong dream. The prohibitive frontier zone between Finland and the Soviet Union had us a little nervous. However, a warmer than expected welcome made us all feel at home. We were greeted with the customary offering of bread, salt, roses, and new guides on Soviet snowmobiles. We also encountered Soviet children, who, like kids everywhere, were full of excitement. They raised our spirits and made each stop worthwhile. A smile and a wave are an international language we all can understand. Many Soviets offered to trade their transportation for ours. We declined, but gave as many free rides as time would possibly allow. As in North America, we ran into all kinds of weather, rain, sleet, snow, and ice. We wanted to symbolize our hope for world peace when we presented a sacred Chippewa peace pipe to General Katsalosin. Like this journey, it signified another bridge cross toward better Soviet-American cooperation. A lack of snow in Moscow couldn't keep us from riding our cats through Red Square. We visited Lenin's tomb, the Kremlin, and the historic St. Basil's Cathedral. As we traveled east to our destination in Siberia, we made many new friends and proved to everyone that people are basically the same everywhere. Peace and friendship were our ultimate goals.
There are images around us and everything we see. Some are real and some are fantasy. To the one who sees his vision, to the child who lives his dreams, you're the one to decide what you're gonna be. So give it your best, and don't you worry about what some may say. Follow your dreams, that's really all that you can do. Give it your best, and remember that life is what you choose. Follow your dreams and do what you love to do. There are places you remember, the times you may recall, faces that refresh your memory. May the thoughts that you will picture help you come to see that you're the one to decide what you're gonna be. So give it your best, and don't you worry about what some may say. Follow your dreams, that's really all that you can do. And give it your best, and remember that life is what you choose. Go on, follow your dreams and do what you love to do. Your best, and don't you worry about what some may say. Follow your dreams, it's really all that you can do. And give it your best, and remember that life is what you choose. Go on, follow your dreams and do it. Follow your dreams and do it. Follow your dreams and do what you love to do. You love to do.
We brought greetings back to you from everyone we met. Let's each do our part to make this world a better place to live. Thank you. Спасибо.